candidates for English. Daryl Delaney, Dave Wasaltzu, am I saying your name correctly? Wasaltzu, Norm Smith, and Dean McKenzie. And here's the question. During the last Legislative Assembly session, there were rumors circulating about the introduction of a carbon tax, similar to the tax in British Columbia. Recent studies have shown that the carbon tax has done nothing in BC to reduce greenhouse gas emissions and has, in fact, served mostly to increase the cost of living to residents of BC and hurt their economy by taking away their competitive edge with their neighbors. Do you support a carbon tax? And if you do, please explain why. And we'll begin with our first candidate for Range Lake, Daryl Delaney.
Okay, thanks, Jocelyn. I guess the purpose of the carbon tax is to do a number of good things according to what we've read in the scriptures. You know, it's supposed to encourage alternatives, raise revenues, and it's kind of a social tax that we all share in the tax burden. However, there's lots of things we got to look at that aren't supportive of such a tax. It's very, very expensive to administer. We got to put those in perspective. People, businesses, and governments have been claimed to this as opportunity for hiding under things like confusing caps and trades, and which is also kind of a misnomer. And by the way, who likes new taxes? I know I'm not a big fan of that. I think it's important that we as a territory develop strategies that reduce our carbon footprint. And I think we have to do a lot of those strategies in other ways and not our dependency on fossil fuels, which we see in a lot of our communities. So given all this, I don't think I can support a carbon tax moving forward. Thank you.
Our next candidate for Range Lake, David Wasaltzu.
Thank you very much for the question. Right off the bat, until there's a North American-wide strategy on greenhouse gas, there really isn't much incentive for any of the jurisdictions in North America to move forward with something. To go out on our own, especially in a territory of our size, just doesn't make sense for businesses or for government. That being said, a carbon tax similar to what BC has done would never work in the territories. I mean, the cost is just too high, and the cost of living is already far exceeds the norm. However, on large emitters and special projects, our carbon footprint is only going up in the territories. If we get resource development actually moving, the carbon footprint is going to move higher. In the past, industry, such as the gold industry, developed a lot of green energy solutions, which was very nice and green for power. But in recent times, everyone's gone to diesel. And we have to move everybody back to hydro. We have to get people using, to remove the dependence on fossil fuels, get off diesel, and stop making diesel the cheapest choice. Right, diesel, the cost comes down to the government, providing the roads, providing all of these things. But we need to have the incentive and the right economic tools to move large emitters onto green energy solutions. It's part of the problem, and we haven't had those tools. So maybe not a carbon tax, but some sort of an economic lever to get those large emitters, and as new mines open up and new industrial development happens, to make sure they're on green energy. Because if we have, you know, 20 more years of fossil fuels happening all across the territories, we're going to have a problem. Thank you.
Thank you. Our next candidate, Norm Smith of Range Lake.
Hi, thank you. I do not support the carbon tax. Our cost of living is already too high. I don't think we can, in fact, I don't support any tax increases, to be quite honest with you. I think we're all paying enough tax, and you know, like I said, the cost of living is too high. Our economy is already suffering, and I think there's other ways that we can go about reducing carbon gases without having to tax people. Thank you.
Thank you. And our last candidate for Range Lake, Pete McKenzie.
I might be supportive of a variable carbon tax similar to that used by British Columbia, which uses the revenues to invest in greener energy solutions such as mass production. But before giving that support, I would like to see a thorough analysis to determine if there would be a net profit. If they did implement that in the government here, that would, with 2012, the federal government is lowering the corporate tax rate. They also want to, for the territories and provinces, to also lower the corporate tax for within their provinces. If that happens, that means the cost of living is going to be put up for us. And a smaller community is already at very high, and they would never be able to afford the difference from that. That means their cost of living goes up, their fuel goes up, everything goes up for them. In that fact, I would not support it. What we have to do is get the mining corporations with the hydro corporation to see if they can come to a mutual agreement that's feasible to make developments for the mines. Thank you.
Thank you.